Namaste friends. Today I am getting to you a very authentic and ancient temple style bhindi curry recipe with freshly made masala paste. I'm including all the tips and tricks of getting this right all the time. And this is a new cooking video experiment where I've included my natural sounds of cooking. I hope you like it. So in this recipe we are using grated coconut. You can also use frozen, or also you can use dry desiccated coconut. In fact, in marriage halls they use actually desiccated coconut because it stays fresh longer. And here is the secret, that's red chili powder. Instead of using actually whole red chilies, for this we are using red chili powder so that it doesn't taste very pungent or very spicy. And we are adding hing also to this. We are only going to use around 1/4 cup of water, and if you want you can add little bit more, but we want a very smooth paste of this. If you add more water before, it won't become smooth paste. And now I'm taking ghee or clarified butter and adding in mustard seeds. I'm going to wait until it splatters. Then I'm adding hing or asafoetida, a very tiny pinch of it. And for this we are taking 1 sprig of curry leaves and we are adding it in. And let it splatter. And for this we are taking chopped bhindi or okra. So this is the size what we need. Don't make it too short, because if you make too short then it won't taste the same. So the length of okra or bhindi or lady's finger, what we call, is very important for this recipe. It has to be little bit medium size, and we are going to fry. You can also make this recipe using coconut oil. It will taste very good even with that. And I'm adding in turmeric. So turmeric is kind of mandatory for this recipe, because turmeric powder not only gives a very nice color and also it has great anti-inflammatory properties, but also turmeric actually cuts down the gooey texture of lady's finger. See, it's almost done. It's fried really well. See, I'll show you. See, this is the consistency we need. And then for this, now we are going to add the tamarind juice. So you can also use tamarind paste, but for this I have taken actual tamarind and I have soaked it in warm water for 20 minutes, and I'm gently going to squeeze it in my hands. So if you don't like tamarind, or if you are not aware of it, then you can also use tomatoes. Substitution will be tomatoes. So make sure that you use a sieve so that we don't get any of those fuzz inside the curry. And now I'm adding in the, see the smooth paste what we have made. So this masala paste is so flavorful that I cannot even explain. It's very tasty. And I'm added some water into it so that I don't like to waste the masala. And now we are going to mix it really well. For this recipe, I have taken rock salt. So I'm adding 1.5 teaspoons of it. Then again, it really depends on your taste, how much salt you need. And I'm adding in jaggery, 2 teaspoons. So jaggery is very important in this recipe. You have to have jaggery in this, or else it won't taste the same. And we're going to mix it really well. You can substitute jaggery with coconut sugar. That will also taste very nice. Look at the curry. It's beautiful. The color is so good. So that's it. It's almost done. Now I'm adding in coriander as a final touch. Here you go. Enjoy it with warm rice. See you next week.